This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA.
Welcome back to Corespun, and in this tutorial, we are going to be making swirls. I will tell you right now that I am not the best at this technique. We all have talents. And hopefully by the end of this video, I will be able to do this somewhat well, but I'm not feeling too confident, so cheer me on. For the base fiber, I'm going to be using Rolags from Classy Squid Fiber Company, and for my swirls, I'm going to be using silk from Camage. So let's get started. My core thread is a tencel blend. It's kind of like cotton, crochet cotton. You can go online and search eBay or Etsy for cotton yarn cone or tencel thread cone, or use mohair or your favorite yarn. Okay, so here's the deal with what I'm going to try to do here. Okay, so I've got a length of dark yardage. Now I'm going to take the Rolag and put it in front. I'm going to spin the silk, core spin the silk behind it. Actually, you know what? I'm going to break this off. But leave a tail because I want that. Okay, so core spin the silk behind it. Nice and tight. There. Now get the tail from my gray section here. We'll put some more twist in this just for good luck. And now, so see right here, I have a tail from my gray Rolag that I broke off, and I have a length of silk. I am going to bring the silk on at a 90 degree angle and hold this tail and wrap the silk on just like that. I don't think I can scrunch it up. I think it's pretty tight. We're going to lock the tip in with the Rolag. And by Jove, we did something. We did something. Let me show you this something that we're trying to do. We're trying to do this. I guess it kind of looks like a seashell. Good morning, camera. Camera needs coffee. Good morning, camera. Yeah. Let's try again. Let's see what else we can do. But that's the basic gist, where we split off from the core. So let's split off from the core. Go rogue with a different fiber, like silk or something shiny. Let's do a long one. Let's see what happens if we do something super long. Get our original core fiber, bring it right toward our belly button, and wrap this on it tightly. Oh, I like that better. I like that better. Okay, let me show this to you close up. That's cool. I did a much better job getting the before and after, like the gray parts, to be more even. So it makes this bumpy, lumpy part look more boutique-y. And it's got over twist for days. Over twist for days. But you can see here's the seashell shaped one and here's the long one. So let's keep playing with that. That is the game of this tutorial. I've seen both, I think I've seen Lexi Boger and JC Boggs and Susie Brown all do this technique. So this is not, none of these are my techniques. I'm just playing and showing you what I've learned. So let's do a lumpy, bumpy, messy section. Messy, messy, thick and thin, really messy. Why not? And then we'll take the end and we'll nice, not bad. I kind of like them. I like these little swirly sections to be weird. This is a very technical yarn though. So if you love to get technical, this should be right up your alley. I like to get messy when I spin. I don't really like to get technical. Which is why my little swirligig creatures that I'm making on this yarn are not perfect swirligig creatures. Each one has its own personality. Pay attention to the end of this one. See how I turn. So after I'm done wrapping the white onto the gray, I then wrap the gray onto the core again to secure it. And that makes it nice and tight. And do be careful when you're bringing these onto your bobbins so that your hooks or your pegs don't hurt them or damage them. We'll do a few more. So watch the angles of my hands as I get to each part of the yarn. That's really the most technical aspect of it, is making sure that your angles lock in the embellishments nice and tight against that core thread. I think I'll do one more. And these swirls you can do with locks, art bats. It could really be any fiber that you want to experiment with for the swirly texture. This one's my favorite. And I accomplished this look. I don't like how loose it is though, so I'm going to scrunch it up and then core spin over the base to lock it in higher. Just like that. That way it doesn't move as much. So the way I made this more kind of swirly looking one is that I went from thin to thick to thin when I was core spinning it. That's odd. Look what's happening here. It's falling apart. Did I not twist it on in the right direction? Whoa, what is happening? Look at this. The whole thing's coming apart. Let's go back to the beginning of this. And let's lock it down again. I'm going to actually bring it up here because I wonder if maybe I didn't have it on. If I wasn't going the right direction, I don't even know. That's disconcerting. I hate it when that happens. I'll have to watch the video and see what I was doing. But now when I let it go, it's fine. It's over-twisted, but over-twisted's better than falling out. I wonder if I went in the wrong direction. That's the only thing that makes sense to me. We'll review the tape. I'll do one more just to make sure that, like, I'm not completely losing my mind. This is just some white from the Rolag. losing my mind? I'm not losing my mind, am I? No, I'm not losing my mind. It was just an opportunity for me to show you how to fix that. Because these are fine. Cool. So that is how you make swirls. It is a challenging technical feat. Takes a lot of practice. And the first couple times you do it, your single is going to be over twisted. And the way to get to a point where it's not over twisted is you can either thread ply it back on itself. Make sure that your ratio is low up here. Make sure you're on the biggest whorl. Use a really forgiving core thread like mohair. I am not using mohair. I'm using a very unforgiving core thread with tencel. So that's making the over twisting problem worse. So yeah, mohair core thread, low ratio, high uptake so that it goes right onto the bobbin before unnecessary twist is created. And if you're still getting issues with over twisting, thread ply it against itself. And then when you get to these swirly gig sections, just allow the thread either to gently wrap around them in between the lumpy bumpy parts, or you can even kind of like skip over them, skip the thread over them. Cool. Awesome. Thank you for watching and happy